మిస్టర్ ఫిలిప్ బోయిల్, ప్రెసిడెంట్ రాయల్ ఏరోనాటికల్ సొసైటీ, పద్మభూషణ్ డాక్టర్ వికే సరస్వత్ అండ్ శ్రీ ఎలంగోవన్ అండ్ డాక్టర్ కె తమిళ్మణి అండ్ ఎమినెంట్ డిగ్నిటరీస్ అండ్ డిస్టింగ్విష్డ్ స్పీకర్స్, ఎస్టిమేట్ డెలిగేట్స్, రిప్రజెంటేటివ్స్ ఆఫ్ మీడియా అండ్ లేడీస్ అండ్ జెంటిల్మెన్, గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ టు ఆల్. I feel truly honored to be here at the inauguration of Aero India 2013 on Aerospace Products, Challenges in Design to Development. I must congratulate Defence Research and Development Organisation, which has been taking the initiative in organizing Aero India seminar every alternate year. On behalf of the Aeronautical Society of India, it is my privilege to welcome you to this seminar. We are most happy to associate with the task of bringing professionals from the field of aerospace science to such deliberations. This type of seminar will provide the required platform for the participants from all over the world to exchange and learn path-breaking new ideas and innovative concepts. This seminar also provides excellent opportunity for the aerospace professionals and institutions to explore technology and research partnership. This seminar on challenges in design to development is a very well and timely chosen. While India has proved its capabilities in research and design across several sectors, India is also becoming a global hub of manufacturing excellence. Today, more than one-third of the global R&D spenders already have centers in India. India is already becoming the automobile manufacturing hub of the world with the presence of top global companies, Mercedes-Benz, BMW, Toyota, Nissan, Chevrolet, Hyundai, and many others. Indian aerospace sector is also gradually shifting from design to development. We already have research and development centers of most of the global aerospace and defense companies fully operational in India. To name a few, Goodrich, Honeywell, Safran, Lockheed Martin, Raytheon, and Pratt & Whitney are among many others who are already here. Not only foreign companies, we also have our esteemed Indian public sector organization like National Aerospace Laboratories, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, Indian Space Research Organization, DRDO, which provides India's innovation and creativity in search for the Indian defense industry. What is required more focus on the development side. And I feel happy to say that we are moving towards that. For example, Airbus recently announced that India will be one of the key centers for design and development of their new A350 aircraft. In defense case, many companies like Tata's and Mahindra's are developing aerospace products. I am most delighted to share that GMR is also doing its best in contributing to growth of commercial aerospace industry in India. Last year, GMR Aerospace Park in Hyderabad Airport provided the infrastructure for the joint venture of Tata and Agusta Westland to establish an ultra-modern helicopter manufacturing unit. If you see, India has got independence 65 years back. Real economic independence has come 20 years back. Indian economy over the years has moved from agro-based economy to knowledge-driven economy. It is very solid and very sustainable economy. 25 years back, people visiting India thought what they could do for this country. Now, the attitude has changed. People visiting India are asking what India can do for them. With a great pride, I can say that no multinational company can afford to be absent from India because of its enormous brain power. In fact, it is estimated that India will add around 11 million to the skilled workforce every year for the next 5 years, and it will account for 25% of the global workforce by 2020. When Ms. Bill Boyle is given a presentation, he has got a challenge for aging workforce. Mr. Philip Boyle, I can say that next 2020 we'll bypass China. China is 351,000. We have India 215,000. I think with a couple of one decade, we bypass China, and we got such a brain power in India. All the parents focusing on the education, the society is focusing on the education now. We are moving to such an economy, economic vacancy. Within the coming decade, we'll grow 5 times in the next decades and will become third largest economy in the world. Historically, Indian entrepreneurship has been well known globally. Given an enabling environment, our country has shown once again that we can accomplish extraordinary heights. Infrastructure development in the areas of telecom and airports has gone up rapidly, with the government giving the opportunity for the private sector to participate. Taking the example of telecom, India is one of the largest and cheapest telecom services in the world, lifting the society underserved society in a significant manner. In the aviation sector, Delhi and Hyderabad airports, built and operate by GMR, have shown the world that India can develop highly complex and mammoth projects on time, delivering world-beating passenger experience. Both these airports are among the top 2 airports globally for service and quality as evaluated by Airports Council of International Switzerland. On the other hand, Indian management skills are being looked at with a keen interest. Indian companies are going into foreign markets, acquiring foreign companies and turn them around. The world is appreciating this Indian leadership, and there has been a remarkable increase in Indian business case studies in the top business schools around the globe. On the occasion, I must mention that India has to create a strong platform to tap the huge potential of transferring its immense capabilities from defense to civil side. Our excellence in defense research, design and manufacturing must focus on civilian applications. In my view, that will be the game changer for its industry. For that, research and development organizations, public and private sector companies, academic institutions, and professional associations have to play a significant role in collaborative environment, and this type of seminar will act as a catalyst to that. Many more major developments on the civilian side are required in our country. You will agree that design and development that benefits society at large will create a sustainable prosperity for our great nation. As our economy and society evolves rapidly, the aeronautical professionals need to grab emerging opportunities. The Aeronautical Society of India is ready to play its role, and I'm confident that we will rise up to this challenge. The future is ours. To conclude, I wish to congratulate all of you for participating in this wonderful seminar for next 3 days. I wish this event a grand success. Thank you.